こんにちは。 I'm Leila from Bisei Japanese. Today, we will learn how to say but, however, as well as even if and even though in Japanese. でも、しかし、けど、けれど、けれども、だけど、が、のに、and でも。 We will learn how to use all of them today.There are so many, and it's very understandable that you find this confusing. でも、but it's not as difficult as you might think. Today, I will teach you the main difference between each of them, and how you can use them to sound more natural and more casual. At the end of this lesson, I will give you a quiz to make sure you remember them all. Does it sound good to you? Okay.じゃあ始めましょう。When connecting two opposing statements in Japanese, we use conjunctions depending on the level of formality in which we are speaking or writing. But it also depends on whether we are using the wordAt the beginning of the second sentence or at the end of the first sentence. So I made a chart to explain. I'm going to explain everything about them, even though I separated them into polite ones and casual ones. You don't actually need to care about it so much. Even if you use casual ones in a formal situation, it's not a big problem. But I want to say that you should be careful usingしかし、のに、and でも。 So, しかし can be used as like however, because しかし isn't often used in daily life. It is often used in more formal text. でも is translated as even if, and のに is translated as even though. でも is used for hypothetical result, and のに is used to show your emotions.It shows that you're surprised or you're disappointed by the result. So, these three have different nuance、compared to other ones. でも、だけど、けど、けれど、けれども、and が are more like a simple but. It may seem like there are so many to remember, but I think it's not as difficult as you might think. けど、だけど、けれど、けれども are also similar. I mean, they are almost the same. If you're a Japanese beginner, I think you can use demo always. Maybe you will sound unnatural sometimes, but who cares? It's more important to practice speaking, right? I use demo and けど in daily conversations. And I use けれど when I want to sound polite. But honestly, it depends on your own personal preference.From now on, I want to teach you about the details of them, especially when they are used at the end of the sentence. You have to be careful about the form of the word that you want to attach the conjunction to. I will explain in this order. First, I will teach you about しかし、けれど、けれども、でも、and だけど。And then I will talk aboutけど、けれども、けれど、and が。And at the end, I want to teach how to use のに and ても。If you want to watch specific parts, please skip the video. Okay, now we will look at でも、しかし、だけど、けれども、and けども。え、けれど。Ah, sorry, how confusing. But they are very easy.They are used at the beginning of the second sentence. Let's see some examples. So,Japanese is difficult, but I will study hard. 日本語は難しいです。でも、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。日本語は難しいです。しかし、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。But be careful, しかし is more often a written word than a spoken one.日本語は難しいです。けれども、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。 日本語は難しいですけれど、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。日本語は難しいですだけど、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。 They are simply used to connect sentences. They don't have any nuances like demo or noni have. But please note that demo and だけど are used in more casual situations. And しかし、けれど and けれども are used in more polite and formal situations. Especially しかし。I don't think many people use it when they speak.I use demo and だけど when I want to talk with my friends and my family. And I use けれども or けれど when I want to talk to people that I want to show my respect to, such as my boss, my teachers, strangers, and people who are older than me. But honestly, they are all that so much different. Let's see some more examples. 日本は好きです。でも行ったことがないです。日本は好きです。でも行ったことがないです。日本語を話せるようになりたいです。だけど勉強はしたくないです。日本語を話せるようになりたいです。だけど勉強はしたくないです。Okay, before we move on to the next chapter, I'd like to teach you one more thing that is common.For native Japanese speakers. Even though I said でも、しかし、けれど、けれども are all used in the middle of the sentence as a conjunction. You can also say them first just before you speak. So for example, like、でも今日寒くない? Or だけど大丈夫なの?しかし、今日の試合はすごかったですね。Like that. You can do this when the listener understands the context. I think it's not grammatically correct, but it's very common for casual speaking. Now let's learn about けど、けれど、けれども、and が。These are used at the end of the first sentence. 日本語は難しいですけど、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。日本語は難しいですけれど、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。日本語は難しいですが、日本語の勉強を頑張ります。Be careful to note that the comma is after them, not before. けど sounds casual, whereas けれど and けれども sounds more polite. As you might know, the shorter the word is, generally the more casual it will be.But が sounds more polite. I use が when I talk to people that I want to show my respect. I'm writing something formal or professional. I don't use が when I talk to my family or my friends. These conjunctions are attached to the word at the end of the first sentence. That means you have to be careful which form you're using for the last word. You can attach them to theplain forms like dictionary form, ta form, nai form, and past nai form. And also to polite forms like des and mas forms. Let's see some examples. 日本語は勉強しますけど、英語は勉強しないです。去年は日本に行かなかったけど、今年は行きたいです。漫画は読むけど、本は読まないです。好きな国は日本だけど、まだ行ったことがないです。Okay, from now on, I want to teach you different use for けれど、けれども、けど、and が。I think this will be very useful for you.You can use these conjunctions at the end of the first sentence, and sometimes you don't have to say the second sentence. For example, 先生、ちょっと聞きたいことがあるんですが。Can you guess the meaning of the sentence? 先生 means teacher. Japanese students call their teacher 先生。 あの is used when you talk to someone. It's just like excuse me. ちょっと聞きたいことがあるんですが。So this means, I have something I want to ask you, but do you have a little time or do you mind helping me or a little bit? So the students want to say,ちょっと聞きたいことがあるんですが、少しお時間いいですか？ Or 今大丈夫ですか？ So it's obvious to the teacher what the student wants to say. So the student doesn't need to say the second sentence. This method is used when you want to express your opinions or when you want to ask questions or request something. This is very usefulespecially if you don't know what to say or even how to say the second sentence. I will give you some more examples. If you accidentally bought the wrong ticket at a train station, then you can bring it to the staff member and say, あの、すみません。間違えて違う切符を買ってしまったんですが、This means, excuse me, I bought a wrong ticket by mistake. Can I get a refund? Even though you didn't say, can I get a refund in Japanese, the staff will pay your money back. You can use this method when you want to express your opinion as well. For example, when your friend says, I think sushi is the most disgusting food ever. Then you can say,
私はお寿司は美味しいと思うけど
I think sushi is tasty though. And this way you can soften your opinion a little bit or add a degree of humility to your sentence. Now let's learn how to say no ni. Like the others, no ni also means but. But this one is a little bit different. You can translate it aseven though, and it is used to express your emotions to something that you didn't expect to happen, like to be surprised or to be disappointed. For example,
10年も日本語を勉強したのに日本語を話せない。
It sounds like, even though I have studied Japanese for 10 years, I still can't speak it.This shows that you are disappointed by this statement.
このチョコレートは高かったのに美味しくない。
Even though this chocolate was expensive, it's not so good. I'm disappointed. You have to be careful of the word that is at the end of the first sentence that noni will be attached to. You can attach noni to a plain form verb or i adjective.Plain form verbs are like the dictionary form, ta form, nai form, and the past nai form. But when you want to attach noni to a noun or na adjective, then you have to add na to the beginning of noni to make it na noni, na noni. Let's see some examples.
彼女は21歳なのにもう4人も子供がいます。彼女は綺麗なのに彼氏がいない。5ヶ月間ダイエットをしたのに1キロしか痩せなかった。彼は身長は高いのに足は短い。
Next, we will learn temo. So this is the last chapter. もう少し頑張りましょう。Okay.
もしテストに合格できなくてもがっかりしないでね。もしテストに合格できなくてもがっかりしないでね。
So don't be disappointed even if you can't pass the exam. So temo is often used with moshi,
which means if in Japanese, and it shows a hypothetical situation. So, てもis て form plus も. So you can just add もto て form of a word. So for example, 明日は雨が降ってもバーベキューをします。服や化粧をきれいにしても心が汚かったらダメよ。My grandma often says it to me. 今は辛くてもきっといいことがありますよ。Okay, now you have learned how to say but, however, even if, and even though in this lesson. Now it's quiz time. I think it will be fun. 頑張ってください。Okay, then please pick the correct one. Number one.
お金がなくカードで買い物ができます。お金がなくカードで買い物ができます。
お金がなくてもカードで買い物ができます。Number two. 明日は日曜日。学校に行かなくてはいけない。明日は日曜日。学校に行かなくてはいけない。
明日は日曜日なのに学校に行かなくてはいけない。
Number three. 熱はあります。咳はありません。
熱はあります。咳はありません。
熱はありますが、咳はありません。So from now on, please pick the one that is wrong. Number four.
今日学校に行った。学校は休みだった。
今日学校に行った。学校は休みだった。
In this case, だけど is the wrong one.
Number five. 先生、すみません。明日、学校を休みたいんです。
先生、すみません。明日、学校を休みたいんです。
In this case, you can't use のに。Number six.
仕事は楽しいです。
楽しいことだけじゃありません。
仕事は楽しいです。
楽しいことだけじゃありません。In this case, you can't use ても。Because temo is usually attached to the end of the first sentence. That's it for today's lesson. I hope you can say but in Japanese confidently from today. Maybe you are overwhelmed by too much information. But that's okay. If you are a Japanese beginner, you can just start using demo or maybe kedo. You can learn little by little. There's no rush.Thank you very much for sticking with me till the end. I appreciate it. I post short Japanese videos on Instagram daily, so don't forget to check it out. I really hope I can see you in the next lesson. またね。バイバイ。